I don't really believe that the eternal question has ever been, where is God? I don't believe that the problem is for the heavens to be open. I believe that they're already open. I believe the eternal question's always been from the beginning, where is man? Where are you, Adam? I've come to walk with you. Why are you hiding behind the bushes?
I think there's these moments in your life where you feel like you're loved well. Like maybe it's, you know, on a birthday when you were celebrated really well. Maybe it's like when you won a trophy. Maybe it's when, you know, you fell down and your mom picks you up and she's like, you're gonna be okay. And you feel in that moment the love is your protection. You're gonna be okay. And when you're in a time of worship where you're really uniting your heart to the nature of the Creator, the nature of God, you feel like a culmination of all those moments and it dwarfs it. It's like you feel like the love and the celebration. It's not just that you're celebrating and loving God. You feel literally like the power of the celebration of being one with God.
Wreckage is, think about a head-on collision. Two cars heading at very fast speeds, colliding with one another. And I believe worship is this space where our heart and the heart of God have a head-on collision. And when you come away from a moment like that, you're never the same.
The heart of God is like bursting out of the universe. Like at the center of the universe is this person called love. And he's a consuming fire. He's a consuming fire. When people see God, they fall on their face. There are thunders, there are lightnings, there's flashes. It's craziness, it's noise, and you can't contain God. Me, at times, it's like I've wanted more. I've wanted there to be places where somehow we can go after more, where it's legal to do that, where it's legal to be really hungry, it's legal to be desperate.
That was the first time I'd ever encountered the freedom in worship, when the Holy Spirit is really given freedom and honored, and when Holy Spirit can lead. So it's not about a prescribed set of songs, but it's really an open environment when, you know, even the people on the stage are just saying, Lord, if you don't come, we have nothing. You know, so even if the Holy Spirit doesn't come, you know, what can we do? So, you know, there's a real, there's a reality about that kind of worship that really refreshes, never known about before in my own experience with God, my own worship, my own meeting Him. It's meeting with Him in the midst of the sounds and the songs and the dances and the colors and, you know, whatever's happening in the room.
I mean, worship, it just comes. You know, you don't have to like work it up. It's just like you look out here. It's like it says in Romans 1, you know, that you know, His divine attributes have been seen by everyone, so that all men are without excuse. So everyone that comes out here, it's like you don't have an excuse to not worship. It's like the beauty of God, the creation is all around you.